YouTube, welcome back to Digital Crypto News. Macro Trends. Give me subscribe if you appreciate that content. I'm trying to give you the hottest crypto content on the internet. H bar, click. Assemble. And I saw some of y'all in the comments thinking Dub Digital forgot about you and all that. That's a rookie mistake, because ODD, I'm back in the seat. I woke up feeling like a freaking winner, feeling like that dude, feeling like a blue chip. And it would only make sense if I covered that blue chip crypto. Dub Digital, why are you calling it a blue chip crypto? Because it's got more blue chip partnerships than I can shake a stick at. That's why. And even when I think the news for this coin can't get any more freaking bullish, Hedera Hashgraph just keeps bringing that fire. And I like that. We're gonna take a look at the price action, cut it up a little bit. But make sure to stick to the end, y'all. Because after that TA, you know I gotta get all up into the FA. Because this is the Dub Digital channel. You know I get that TA and the FA, and I mix it all up. Spoiler alert, y'all. You know how Hedera Hashgraph got everyone and their mom up in their governing council? Shocker, someone else just got added to the list. And we already got Africa and Australia and the United States all up in this thing, but now it's Korea's turn. But you know what? I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's pull up the chart. All right, guys, I'm sitting on the H-bar USD pair. Let's get it. The whole premise of this channel is buy low and sell high. And it almost feels like just yesterday, little H-bar was out there playing around, sitting down there at what, 2 to 4 cents for a pretty long time. 132 days to be exact. And let me tell you something, guys. H-bar at that point, it wasn't sexy. It wasn't pretty. No, everyone's laughing at it. But what do they say, guys? One man's trash is this man's treasure. Between the dates of September 2020 to January of 2021, yeah, we were scooping all of that. Both hands, both feet, putting H-bar in my shirt. Taking H-bars from little kids? Nah. I don't condone taking H-bar from little kids, but y'all catch my drift. But Dub Digital, why would I want to buy something when no one's talking about it? It's flying under the radar, because most people, they only look at the chart, but they don't respect the investing art. And after everyone and their mom was complaining about H-bar not doing nothing, H-bar looked at its haters and said, screw y'all, I'm out of here. And over the next 67 days, H-bar started shooting up to the sky, making me all bullish as hell. And at the highest point of the wick, H-bar topped out at around 46 cents. Guys, that's about a 1,000% gain. I'ma take that any day of the week. When I zoom up, y'all, you'll see that I drew two dotted lines, one coming across the top and one coming across the bottom of the forming structure. It's sloping rather aggressively to the upside. This is what we call an ascending triangle. And within that triangle, we have a W pattern. Don't believe me? Check it out. And what else do we know about W's, y'all? W is for winners. W's are for wolves. Feed on this Hedera goodness. Dub Digital, this thing ran up a whole bunch. You don't think it's gonna give some back? Guys, look at the pattern. W typically means bullish. Look at the ascending triangle. Those typically are bullish. Price action, winding inside of this structure, respecting the bottom trend lines. That's a bullish indicator. And even though the move isn't 100% done, and we're gonna have to watch this price action to see if it abides by the lines of the bottom and top trend lines. What I see on this chart is Hedera has been winding, coiling up, building pressure for its next move higher. But let's apply the Fibonacci retracement tool to this sucker to see if a healthy correction actually has already occurred. Measuring from the top of the wick to about the absolute low was a correction of close to 40%. Jeez. And what do we know about 40% corrections? That puts us right around the golden pocket, aka the 61.8 Fibonacci level, aka the reload zone. And that just happens to be an area where a lot of traders tend to reload up on positions they take profit on. And you'll see right here, guys, the Hedera Hashgraph, it touched the golden pocket, but it wasn't there for long. The expediency of H-bar dipping into that golden pocket and popping back out, not once, but twice, adds to the bullish sentiment I have for this structure forming out. But Dub Digital, I don't get it. Why are W patterns bullish? Because the structure of the W forms something called a double bottom. See? One bottom, two bottom. This tells us that there's some investors sitting out there eating up all the H-bar, dropping down to about the 30 cent level. It entered that zone once, bounced up. And entered that zone again, bounced up. And somewhere within the next 19 days, this structure comes to an end. Dub Digital, what the hell does that mean? Well, it means that something's gonna happen. Let's go ahead and do a measured move. Should H-Bar continue to coil up in this ascending triangle and break up to the upside, I think the next leg higher is gonna take us around 70 cents. And at the price point of the time of filming this video, that's about an 85% move. I wouldn't be mad at that. But guys, in full transparency, we do have to keep an eye on the volume profile right about here, because it's always good to see volume build into the move with price action breaking out. And by just analyzing the volume profile, we can clearly see the volume has been decreasing ever since March of 2021. We're gonna need to see some volume build into this move right around the tip of this ascending triangle, or else we'll have a divergence. But the ball game ain't over, guys. It might just want to prove its haters wrong again. And y'all know I'm down with that, because I hate haters. Yeah, whatever, Dub Digital. You always talking that filth, flarm, filth, bro. Everyone knows Hedera's just a one-hit wonder because they got Google all up in their council. Ah, I see you're full of rookie mistakes today. That's it, guys. We're going to have to take off the boxing gloves. I'm tired of this TA. Let's go ahead and get up into the FA, because this is the Dub Digital channel. You know I get that TA and the FA, and I mix it all of that fundamental analysis, because those closer to the knowledge profit. Simple as that. If y'all know any H-Bar haters, I want you to forward them this video, because Hedera's been out here doing it hard, doing it dirty. It's got its fair share of naysayers. I'm more of a yaysayer, and I know the blue chip crypto, it's just getting started. Y'all ain't gotta believe me, just check this out. Dated April 13th of 2021, 1 billion Hedera mainnet transactions. They start this article off like a straight beast. A million transactions isn't cool. You know what's cool? 1 billion transactions. Or shall I say 1 billion transactions. All right, guys, my bad. I've been sitting in this room too long. It took Hedera mainnet 1 year, 6 months, and 28 days to reach 1 billion transactions. For context, a billion transactions is a big deal for any public ledger. Bitcoin blockchain is approaching 700 million transactions. Ethereum recently surpassed 1 billion transactions this year. I'ma let that sink in. I'ma let it sink in some more. We got 10-year-old blockchains not hitting a billion transactions. Hedera has only been around for a fraction of that time. Hashgraph transactions being clocked, they're actually being done by bona fide companies, entities, corporations, entities of sizes that would boggle the mind. With over a billion transactions, Hedera has arrived and is arguably the most trafficked mainnet, with millions of transactions occurring each and every day. This is a combination of the maturing market, Hedera's technological advancements, and the network's ability to support higher throughput use cases. Hedera ain't just having transactions for, well, the sake of having transactions. Looks like Hedera is starting to really pique the interest of not just a few big names in the governing council, but a broader interest. And that, my friends, is what's gonna make the number really go up. Another one, dated April 5th of 2021. IBM blockchain platform tech preview with Hedera Consensus Service. Permission networks forming private ledgers are a great way to securely share information between a set of known and participating entities. And that information needs to serve a purpose outside the network's confines. Those deployments become no more trusted than a shared database. To enhance the integrity and extend the audibility outside of the network's operators, private ledgers can work alongside a public ledger like Hedera. A leader in permission networks, current Hedera governing council member, IBM, ever heard of them, wants to formalize this model. With its high throughput and predictable low fees, the Hedera Consensus Service makes this hybrid model viable for enterprises. There we go. What else do y'all gotta hear? Hedera Hashgraph is working lockstep with IBM. IBM and Hedera are trying to tailor HBAR in a way that makes it not only a good fit for enterprises, but the fit for enterprises, offering both privacy for the entities, transparency for an auditor, but most importantly, flexibility for regulators. And guys, it's not like this is a hope, wish, and a prayer. No, Hedera's already got Standard Bank and Hala systems up and running in this thing. Dub Digital, we're all deep up in this video, and you still haven't told me who the new member of the Hedera governing council is. Guys, chill the hell out. I'ma get to it. Dated April 13th of 2021, Shinhan Bank furthers digital transformation plans, joins Hedera governing council. Told y'all, I ain't lying. Shinhan Bank, the leading bank in South Korea, has joined the Hedera governing council. Is this a freaking joke? Hedera's damn near taking over the world right now, and it's getting me bullish as hell. Shinhan Bank is a leader in leveraging distributed ledger technology, or DLT, to drive financial innovation. In January of this year, Shinhan invested in Korea Digital Asset Custody, or KDAC, an industry consortium of businesses that provide digital asset custody service. In March, Shinhan completed a demonstration platform for central bank digital currencies, or CBDCs, together with LG? Whoa. I used to think Stellar Lumens was the CBDC coin. Hedera Hashgraph's been talking to Australia, to countries in Africa. They're bringing Korea up in the mix? Holy smokes, guys. Our clients and partners are increasingly interested in the benefits that digital transformation can provide for improving the efficiency and security of financial systems. Hedera's public distributed ledger, in particular, is uniquely suited to meet the needs of a widely used fintech service that must be fast, fair, secure, and enable the controls and visibility required by service providers. We are excited to join the Hedera Governing Council on solutions that will underpin the next generation of finance. Oh my God. If you can't tell how bullish that is, you might want to go slap yourself. Maybe even twice. Hedera's out here. Blue chip crypto is killing it. Not financial advice, but I don't know how many partnerships y'all gotta see to see where this asset is going. Hashgraph's slowly starting to make the transition from experimental new technology to perhaps a quantum leap in technology. All right, guys. I just wanted to bring you an update on HBAR because I seen the price moving sideways and I said my HBAR homies might need me because HBAR, it's been coiling up in that ascending triangle. We got to keep an eye on the volume, but what excites me the most isn't necessarily the price action, guys, because y'all know price action is just a symptom of fundamentals, and that's something HBAR got a lot of, like a lot. Even in its infancy, it's challenging legacy blockchains and transactions occurring on its mainnet. Bitcoin's almost 10 years old and it hasn't even hit a billion transactions on it yet. HBAR is doing that like it's easy, like it's fun, like it can do it every other Tuesday. IBM tinkering on Hedera, trying to make the perfect enterprise solution. But most importantly, we have another member of the Hedera Governing Council, South Korea's largest bank, all up in the mix. If you guys can't get bullish off of that news, you might want to check your pulse. But hey, y'all ain't gotta believe me. This is not financial advice. I'm just a dude on the internet. If you appreciate the content, give me a like, comment, subscribe, Dub Digital, crypto news, macro trends. I'll talk to y'all later. Peace.